I'm Dr. Lakshmi Satish, Senior ENT Surgeon practicing at Skin Cosmetic ENT Care Center and at Sagar and Excel Care Hospitals. Vertigo is nothing but a medical term used for giddiness. It can be explained by the patient of lightheadedness or woozing or blackout or feeling temporarily unsteady. It can be either a patient himself feeling that he is revolving, or he can experience the whole environment revolving around him. So it can be a rotatory vertigo or a objective vertigo where he himself feels that he is rotating. There are many causes for this scary condition called vertigo. One of the commonest things a person experiences is because of a sudden blocked eustachian tube. After a flight or after diving or scuba diving, etc., they can experience a dizziness because of a clogged eustachian tube. If the eustachian tube has to supply sufficient air to the middle ear, if that is not achieved, they can have a momentary giddiness. Apart from that, there are many inner ear causes which can cause giddiness. One of the commonest things is what we see in the clinics is a condition called BPPV, benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. A person experiences severe giddiness on lying down or on getting up or on turning in bed. This can happen for no reason, or when we probe, we can elicit a history of previous minor head injury or some other injury impact on the head, which results in the formation of small particles of calcium carbonate crystals called otoconia. When they circulate freely in the inner ear fluids, they do not cause any disturbance. But if due to sudden change in pressure, when they float freely, that results in giddiness. So that condition is called BPPV. So we examine, correctly diagnose, and teach them certain exercises to reposition these particles. So we have to teach the patients reposition exercises to cure this condition. The second commonest condition is Meniere's disease. It is characterized by sudden fluctuating hearing loss with a sudden deafness and blocked ear, severe pressure in the ear associated with tinnitus or sound in the ear. When you take the proper history, the classical triad of these symptoms will be there, and a patient with an acute Meniere's attack can experience quite scary and severe form of vertigo. That has to be analyzed, diagnosed properly, and treated appropriately. Other condition is vestibular migraine. A person who suffers from repeated attacks of migraine can also suffer from vertigo, because vertiginous migraine is another form of migraine. Here also we counsel the patient, take the detailed history, come to a correct diagnosis, evaluate them properly, and give them vestibular sedatives along with the treatment of migraine that will cure the condition. We have to always reassure the patients. Another condition is vestibular neuronitis, where there is an infection of the inner ear nerves leading to deafness along with giddiness. We have to diagnose appropriately, do the correct investigations, and treat it accordingly. Another condition for giddiness is vestibular schwannoma or acoustic neuroma, a slowly growing tumor from the inferior vestibular nerve. It can gradually expand in the inner ear canal and cause vertigo along with progressive unilateral hearing loss. We have to always keep this condition in mind whenever we have an elderly person coming with a progressive hearing loss, tinnitus, and giddiness. Simple form of migraine also can sometimes present with vertigo, especially in children. So these are some of the common ENT causes of giddiness. There are so many other central causes of giddiness, such as vertebrobasilar insufficiency, etc., which we will not be discussing today. Thank you.